again with Mystery of Fortune. Playing this yesterday. Had a pretty good time with it. Actually, when I stopped streaming, I continued playing the game the entire rest of the day. I've probably put another 8 to 10 hours in at this point, beyond what I streamed. Trying something new today. I'm actually recording and streaming. We'll see if my hardware can handle that. And I will be posting this video on YouTube. So if you're watching this on YouTube, you can check out my Twitch stream and see the first part. Learned a couple of things. Not everything yet, but... I lost the game. Hang on. There we go. Alright, if you go over to this controller here in the bottom, you can save your data to the cloud and load it back in order to transfer between devices. I'm going to reload my data now as I put it on my phone earlier. It's rather quick. Okay, go on and start here. I'm actually just about to redo my team a little bit. I just leveled up a bunch. I found this giant dungeon hiding over here. When you come on up, it's sort of off to the side. Appears to be like an optional dungeon. Looks like there's another one over here with the little orange dashes. And it gives insane amount of gold. All you have to do is complete maybe the first 4 or 5 dungeons, and it gives me more gold than I was getting from 50 levels in this other dungeon. So that worked out really well for me. Let's see, hop over here into the mercenaries. You can see I've leveled up a little bit. Got my healer at 125 and the sorcerer at 115. I now have alchemist at 100, the temple knight, which is awesome, at 125. I may be keeping the temple knight around for a very long time. I got a ways to go still. I started leveling up my cleric and I popped my summoner up to 100. I have not used the summoner yet, so we're going to see how that goes now. And I still find the music very catchy. Not yet annoying. So here's my current layout. Running the 2 gold guys in the front. Temple Knights, very good. They heal themselves just like the soldier does. I'm still using my soldier as, in order to unlock some of the other units, I had to level him up pretty high. And so his stats are still very good. These guys I just leveled up over 100 right before I started streaming. So he was actually higher in hit points this entire time. Looks like they're doing better on attack now. And have higher defense. So this guy will be phased out here shortly, if not right now. I haven't really decided what I'm going to do. I've been using the alchemist, which actually started getting me pretty far. The current dungeon I'm fighting in, I was dying on the 9th level every time. And I put the alchemist in here, and I've been getting up in the 20s now. We'll go over here to detail real quick. I learned this. That's another neat trick I found. If you touch and hold, you get pop-up of the skills, which is extremely handy. In the top right corner, it shows you the ether cost. Oops. Come on. It's not 100%, but click and hold seems to do it. Maybe. Oh, I lose it now. Okay, well, now I'm not able to do it again. Go back in. There we go. So it shows you the range, what it targets, and an explanation of what it does, which is not always very useful. But with potion, I've been using this as the first ability, potion of ice, to freeze the closest enemy to start a battle. As long as we have 10 points of ether, which is usually not that hard. Then the Potion of Miracle is a speed attack and something else buff. What is it? Yeah, and defense. I wasn't sure if it was defense. And then a Potion of Protection seems to put up like a shield. I'm using that on my defensive guys when they start losing hit points. And she can resurrect. So That helped a lot. I'm actually probably going to ditch her at this point to put my cleric in, even at a lower level. That's the current plan, as I just leveled up and have some more space here. I also wanted to get the summoner in instead of the sorcerer. So let me go ahead and drop you in, and you. And if we take you out, still not enough. Unless I drop him. I can give it a shot. We'll see what happens. So I've already got my summoner geared up. She's going to summon fairies once Ether gets over 100 and doing normal attack to closest enemy. Until then, once we get Ether up to 400, we'll summon a Kirin, and if she breaches 700, we'll do a dragon. I've got it split up that way because they're fairly expensive. A fairy at 55, Shiva's 200, I skipped over that one, to go for Kirin at 240, and the dragon's 360. So, didn't want to use up all the Ether, and I also didn't want to summon the dragon when there was no need for it. So I went ahead and set that to over 700, and we'll see if that works. Lots and lots of gear. So far I have not run out of space. There still seems to be quite a good bit left. Again, it's very handy that once you equip gear, it no longer shows up here in the inventory list, saving you some room. I was removing any item that was below level 24. Now I'm removing items that are below 40 automatically, because I'm not going to put anybody that low level into combat. Unless I have to. My sniper got moved off, as I'm using the cannoneer now. Nope, don't need the armor. My helmet's low enough, I can leave it on there. I stopped using the healer. See, I just pulled the sorcerer out. So my temple knights. I want another set of that armor. Best I found, and I just got this shield. Handy. Shields are rather weak compared to most of the other gear, but every little bit helps. Let's see what the cleric can wear. The normal armor is plus defense, and then the robes are plus magic defense. For the characters in the back line, the magic defense is useful for when they get hit by the magic attacks. A lot of magic attacks hit all your characters. But when the front line falls, or if an enemy for some reason goes through the front line and runs to the back, they're going to hit them with physical attacks. And so for the most part, I've been using just the standard armor on my back line. As I start getting a little bit higher up, I've been starting to equip these magic defenses, but also you can see that backline type characters all have a high magic defense to start. So, 40. For the most part, I've been going off how many hit points it gives them as to whether or not I equip it. It's a pretty quick and dirty way to tell the level or the quality level of the gear. I've noticed sometimes the defense is not always higher and may even be the same on items with higher HP, so I've been using that to judge. Let's see, have a weapon. 38 magic, 46 magic. That's about all that you're going to get until we level you up some more. I have some nice items in here for levels 101. I think the highest thing I have is for a level 235. Again, one of the things that got me on this game was that one of the screenshots showed the characters going up to level 999. So, pretty excited to see that. Got a lot more macros here also now. The list is quite extensive. Still missing a few of the in-betweens, and I have not figured out exactly how they unlock. because the issues I was having with healing before, I've started doing anytime a friendly gets below 90%. Heal. Something that I did find a post on Reddit about this game. It was more about the second one, but people were talking about this one as well. And from what I was able to gather, you don't have to fill up all the macros. They're in priority order, only such that if both conditions are met, is an example because I have two here now, that it will follow the first one first and the second one second. Once firing off the first one, if the second condition is still met, and then it'll do the second ability, which may also be why my healing was failing. So we remove the healing up to the top. Wait, anytime anybody's hurt, we should get a heal done. And follow that up with a protection spell. I like to do the ability first. And all the way at the bottom for disabled. That way if somebody dies, they get healed. Target that as the first ability. Not really sure how to target off cure. I don't think that I've gotten macro for poison yet. Oh, I unlocked yourself with hit points more than 60% and 30%. Very useful, rather than just targeting self. I guess we'll go with 40%. We'll do a cure. If they're down there, they're probably poisoned. And I don't ever want you to attack. That way you should not get aggro. And the cleric has auto ether gathering. So I no longer have to have a macro for that. Alright, for my cannons. Turn you off. Turn you off because it's not important. Now, I have noticed, though, that whatever's in the first slot, if possible, fires off immediately at the beginning of the round. And so, for some things like the self-heal on the knights, I don't want that on the first ability, because then everybody else rushes past them and gets aggro, and I was killing my sorcerer over and over again for no reason. So I did make that change. Let's put it this way. I want to poison the farthest at the beginning of battle, and then fire on the closest, and if you can't do either one, then do a normal attack. So I'm getting the hang of this a little bit better. Oops. So we want reverse order. Similar to setting up Tasker. I used to use Tasker a lot on my Android phone. And I think this will make everything work a lot better. Anytime HP is under 90% heal. Charge closest enemy. Oh, you know what? We're not even using Brad anymore. Never mind. I'm going to clean these guys up anyway. And see, like here, this would be a confusing set of macros, and which is probably why my character didn't do much but poison arrow. Because they're all set for the same status. And it's only going to trigger the poison arrow because every time it has the mana. I guess if one of these had lower mana cost, yeah, charge shot would be cheaper. If it didn't have enough mana or ether for poison arrow, then it would fire up charge shot. And if it didn't have enough for a charge shot, then it would normal attack and it would skip the fire arrow every time. Change this. Say an enemy with less than 40%, we'll do charge shot, see if we can do a one-shot kill. healer. We can light him on fire. And last case is normal attack. So I'm not going to continue, but I do want to close these out. That way if I do end up using that character again, I'll be able to see that I need to update. The macro system makes a lot more sense now, and I should be able to do a better job. And see, like this one, she was constantly gathering ammo. Need a knight anymore for anything. Yeah, see, my healer did nothing but gather ether because of the way I set this up. Keep yourself alive, priority. Keep friendlies alive, priority. Let's go. Friendly at 80%. We'll trigger that before the 90%. So heal yourself if your hit points low is primary ability. If you find anybody at 80% or less, then heal everybody or the group. It doesn't say how many people. If you go to multi-healing, it just says up to 5 nearby. Hopefully they're all close enough. It doesn't give me a range on that. And if the range is 1, then that's horrible. And if anybody gets below 90%, heal them immediately. So hopefully we won't hit the multi-heal. And then if you can't do any of that, gather ether. See, I did the same kind of thing here where I don't have it very well set up. Take that. Found the frozen attack to work best. The firewall actually damages your own heroes, apparently. So I stopped using Firewall. Anyway, with the Frozen Bolt, it hits multiple. And it's not in a straight line, which also the Firewall was missing most enemies, as they would just walk around it. But anyway, Frozen Bolt has a chance to freeze them and hits a cluster. So. Anybody that can heal, anybody under 90. Then closest. Probably don't need that middle one, but I'm not using you anymore, so suck it. See, these I had set to self. I can now fix this. Self. Say it's 60%. And not only does that make more sense, but now I see how you can use the AND command. So heal if you need to, then charge the closest enemy. And do the whirlwind attack, which isn't really a whirlwind, it just spins one time. So it should be a spin attack, but hey. There's an enemy with lower than 40%, we're doing a normal attack. Yeah, we don't even need that. Oh, I know why I had that in there, never mind. That was a target, a low HP hero, I mean enemy, so we could try and kill them all faster. I'm gonna prioritize that. Always should have a default drop down ability that it can just do instead of standing idle. I want to try something. Say an enemy with 20%, we'll do an end breath of life. It's basically an attempt to assassinate. Barely uses any energy and has a really low chance of success. Wish you could copy these, because now I gotta do it again. Thank you. 60%. Hopefully I can get an 80% unlocked. So I would like to have that if at all possible. Enemy 20%. End of life. Oh, that one should have been first. Then self heal. 16. Like I said, I still haven't figured out why some of these things unlock. It's just that sometimes I get another macro. Not yet figured out why. I'm setting all these up. Decided to drop my enemy to 30% for the normal attack. So I'll do a hit and then try the end of breath. Hopefully you won't sit there and do end of breath over and over and over again and never do the normal attack. Because that only takes... Well, it takes 100. We'll see. Heal first. Slightly concerned about this one. They're going to cure and not heal. I really need like a 50% on the friendly. Something between the 80 and the 40 that I have now. That's not what I wanted to do. Let's do this one. Anytime a friendly hits 20%, we want to heal. Constantly. There we go. That way they'll heal first. If it drops below 40% instead of curing. And then once they're over 20%, it'll move on to cure. And they should be healing automatically at 90%. And if they're not healing, they should cast Protect. Might go with Random Friendly instead of Closest. Where there's a chance to hit more than one. On my Cannon, who I really need to level up some. Oh, you can have a shield. They have high HP, we'll poison them. Until I get carpet bombing, there's not too much else I want him to do. Fortunately, it just says devastating artillery. At least the carpet bombing says high damage instead of just damage. Default normal attack if nothing else. poison anybody under 90%. I guess we can just do an 80%, a 70%. I don't have 80. If they're under 70, do fire. If they're under 90, do poison. Otherwise, bomb closest. Do... random. Just didn't see anything that I really wanted. I guess I could always target the enemy with the highest attack, and then just in case I don't have any ether left. Alright, so I'm gonna set up. I think that's, we made it all the way around. Okay. And we got a normal attack in there just in case. Normal attack, normal attack. Alright, let's see what happens. I'm afraid that not having a three-man front line, I'm going to lose somebody, but we're off. I can have that one. Oh, level 132. 124. 112. 104. It's interesting. I have not seen those before. The goods do rotate. Sometimes you go in there and it'll only be one style of equipment, like all mage weapons or all helmets. See constant ether gathering. I like to watch the hit points more than the actual battle. Make sure Wei's HP goes up. I need to turn off normal attack for my sorceress because she's going right into combat. You would think she'd shoot a magic ball or something. I believe we just had a summon. I didn't see it anywhere. But I think if, let me slow it down. Watch, there'll be like a card. There it is, the fairy summon. I do not see the fairy though. So, not really sure about that. Looks like we're losing Jonathan. Some healing. So it looks like the ether gathering is significantly lower on auto than it was on the ether gathering with the healer. Because I would definitely be in the 800 range right now on ether. And it's over 410. Oh, summoner is tanking. Oh, and she's down. Run away, cannoneer. Oh, can you? No. So that didn't go very well, but you can see I got 32,000 more funds, only level 11, or tier 11. That looks nice. And I still popped my dirigible. It's up to 40,000 now. Okay. Did not go to the right dungeon. Stay in here, please. So I did go to the 500 level dungeon that's above, and I made it to 4-3. I haven't been back. I've improved a lot since then, but you never know. Yeah, see, now we're all wands. Summer. Why not? Only 23 levels? I probably, well, I might make, no, I'm not gonna make that. Not even close to it yet. Yeah. Not with that horrible run. How about a plus 74? Wow. Oops. .508. We'll get you out of combat and get you some more magic defense. So we definitely don't want normal attack. Find out what retreat to base does. Then I'm gonna add in. Do I have a? Is there 200? No, I need that middle range there. Could do an either. Oh well, we'll leave it like that. So in order to get my ether to go up higher, I'll take my guys here. Yes, he doesn't heal until 60%, so he wasn't eating up all that ether. Like a 70%, to be honest. I just realized what I did. Yeah, I've got 90 and 60. So whirlwind's 57. Yes, we're doing a lot of whirlwinds. Start healing at 70%. That way, you should just sit there idle gathering ether. As long as nobody's HP is below 70. Oh, 40. Enemy at 70. That might be a problem. Okay. As long as nobody's hit points drop below 80%. Or dies, she should just gather ether. I noticed she didn't resurrect. It's only 120. Now, what I have learned is resurrection does have to occur on the same round that they died. If you go to the next level, you cannot bring them back. Yeah, so you're never doing closest enemy unless we run out of mana. I mean, ether. Give that a shot. I don't expect to get too much farther, but money, money. Whoa, my chair leans really far back. There. Oh look, 194 already. Well, verse 4, maybe that did help. I believe there's also a cooldown, like on the summons. And that's why you don't see it triggering every time I get 100 ether. May have to bring my second or my healer back just to do an occasional heal and to gather ether. Because I need a lot more than that. Another thing that I've learned is the bags. When you pick them up in the dungeon, you have a limit of 18. Once you hit 18, you just don't pick up anything else. And there's nothing you can do about it except for teleport back to town, sell off everything, and then start back where you left off at. I think the next level is a giant spider. Yeah, we didn't reach it last time. It's like a 10th floor boss. Was that Sword Art Online had it? Kill Jonathan. So my summoner spends a lot of time sitting there idle. And dying. Okay, floor 11. Maybe something useful there in that staff. Let's do our dirigible. Grab another 40k. Oh, this one again. I may have to, well, I guess if I get the ad-free version, I wouldn't be able to do this, so I'm not sure. Thought about it. I do like the 40k. Oh, that's another thing. On my phone, across the top is a banner ad, because this is the ad version. It's not here in this, because I believe Nox is blocking it. Let's see what there is for sale. This is the normal for this area. Short sword, the wooden wand, jumbo cannon, the book. cannon? Oh yeah, much better. Oops. Oh, don't change. Sell the lower level gear that I just got. Improvement there. Healing's still not working really well. Really want that 60% for cure, and then I can get rid of this guy completely. Or that one? I don't know. The protect isn't firing at all. I don't want it going off all the time. Yeah. Alright, I think I have these set up properly. Love something between 100 and 400. Treat the base is keeping her out of the way. Guess we could do this. I think I will just run a handful of these over and over again for a bit, see if I can level up again. I keep forgetting, but you really kind of want to drink a beer one time after every battle, so you can keep everybody happy. And let's run it a few times. Seems to be doing okay so far. See what happens when we get the big spider. Jonathan seems to be managing his heals pretty well. Watching those HP. Jonathan's dead. We got a resurrection in. Oh, Carson's dead. And the mage's dead. Sork is dead, and Canada's dead. We didn't even make it past that. Uh-oh. Looks like my click's not working again. Are we gonna crash? I did notice there's a new Nox player out. May have to update. Huh, back button works when I can't click on the screen. Good to know. Dirigible! I didn't laugh. Some of it was amusing, but I didn't laugh. Actually, let's see what's for sale. Why not? Maybe four of those. Couple of those. It's only money, right? And he can't wear any of them. What is it? 124 the minimum? I could get one of them up to 124. Poof, they're gone again. Getting there. Oh wait, they did get there. And for you, 480, 820. Wow, big difference. Okay. Oh. Why didn't you say so? That'll help. That hat's better. I do 215. Level 278. Wow. I'll hold out. 128. He's right there. We're close enough. Need to get you level some. More healing. Actually, tired. I have to work tonight. Let's swap it. We'll probably never cure or protect. Until I get something for cure, I don't even know if I should bother. A wrap. Have beer on me. Good. Didn't notice that before. And we kill some more. More minutes this. No, I'm not expecting any better performance this time. Maybe a little bit with the extra damage and defense, but not a lot. I'm just grinding to get another rank up. And I can have Brad back in, or maybe the healer. Ooh, Ether higher than 600 unlocked. I don't know if you noticed. Rewind if you want to see it. The new macro just randomly shows up. Not determined why. It's not because I beat the dungeon floor, because I've already finished that one several times. I believe it has to do with the number of uses of other macro skills. But I haven't been able to confirm that, as what you would think would happen doesn't. I mean, the only one I've used is Ether 100 so far, so I'm not getting over 100 Ether very far. Going. Oh wow, extra heals maybe. Ooh, they were chasing my cannon. And looks like it's all over with the Dryan. Oh no. We just lost the healer. That'll make it end pretty quick. Go Carson. Wow. He's a tanking machine. That's why I like the self-heal. Would've been long since dead otherwise. Wow, Carson. He's the man. successfully keeping aggro too. It's impressive. With no healer. And stunned. It was just a meat shield. And we lost aggro. Oh, if we lose our cannon, it's over. We have no ether gather either. Man, what was in that helmet he got? Nice run. I was actually really making it to level 22, 24 before I started streaming and changed my lineup from the Alchemist. Didn't I pull a nice 44,000 war fund though? Yeah, 44. Here's another 40. Maybe scarred for life, but it was an easy 40k. 618 away from new rank. More wands. Level 23. It's low level this time. Oops. Didn't mean to do that. Alright, more upgrades for next time. This will be the last run. I'll go ahead and do the upgrades after this run and then I'll stop the stream. It is a rather boring game to watch considering I'm just sitting here most of the time. Rank up my knights so they can all use their new armor. Hello? Okay, that was weird. Did I start over at the beginning? I went to the wrong town. I went to the beginning town. I'm such a loser. I got decent gear though. Where did that come from? So apparently the dungeon level does not entirely affect the gear available. Oh. Yeah, Brad might have to come back and leave it. Have a real shield, buddy boyo. Bloop. Bloop. Nice. Johnny boy, what do you need for that armor? 132 was our target. That's 7. Oh yeah, barely. I don't think you're gonna make it, are you? enough to get you up 9. I mean, only 7 though. Hmm. Still won't make 7. Nothing good for a new weapon. Mud head. 340. Unlock the priest. Now that I finally got my cleric in a reasonable place. Create a cloak. Upgrade the wand. No upgrade to the cannon. What we got here? Cures all allies from debuff and restores half their health. Holy crap. Every dead ally. Woof! Priest upgrade it is. Wow. Be a while before I can put you in the party, but... Oops. I didn't mean to try and buy it. I know I couldn't. We have 2,000. Let's do a monster race to end this. You can see I haven't done too much since then. Goblin's a fast little booger. Not real feeling the zombie day. I'm thinking the skeleton's gonna win. We'll pick the goblin though. What? Oh, it's 24,000 here. Holy cow, patties. Man. Didn't know that went up. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and end the stream. I'll probably run the dungeon after this time. I'm probably gonna upload the data again and then download it back to my phone. And upgrade my Nox player. So, you guys have fun. If anybody ever watched this, glad you did. Again, semi-boring game to watch somebody else play, but if you're into that, more power to you. Thanks for stopping by.